Hi everyone, Aaron here for zollotech, and I wanted to show you the easiest way to reset your Mac back to factory default if it's an M1 or Apple Silicon based Mac running macOS Monterey or newer. And so the first thing is you will need an M1 or Apple Silicon based Mac, meaning one of the latest MacBook Airs, MacBook Pros, or iMac or Mac Mini running Apple's own chipsets. If you have that and macOS Monterey, you can check for macOS Monterey by clicking the Apple and then going to About This Mac. You'll see macOS Monterey here. If you have that or a newer version by the time you're watching this video, this method will work for you. And when it's reset, everything will be erased, your Apple ID will be removed from the device, and it will be returned to just like it was when you took it out of the box for the first time. And so before we get started, just make sure you have a backup, as this will erase everything off the device and you won't be able to recover it unless you have a backup on an external drive or in the cloud somewhere. So let's go ahead and close this. And let me show you how to do this. It's very simple, and you will need your Apple ID, and typically you'll want a network connection as well. So we want to go to System Preferences. Click on System Preferences, and if you don't have it here, you can either search for it with the little search icon in the upper right, or you can go to Finder, click on Applications, scroll down, and you'll see System Preferences. Once you're in System Preferences, go ahead and click at the top where it says System Preferences. Then click Erase All Content and Settings. And so here it's going to ask for your password. Go ahead and put in the password, the same one you would log into the computer with. Once you've entered your password, you'll see it says Erase All Content and Settings. All settings, media, and data will be erased. The following items will also be removed. It's going to remove your Apple ID, Touch ID, any fingerprints that were stored on the computer, any paired accessories, as well as Find My and activation locks. So as long as you want to remove that, go ahead and click Continue. Here it's going to ask us to sign out of our Apple ID. In order to do that, we're going to have to be connected to a network, like I said before, and you'll also need the password for your Apple ID. Typically, it's going to be similar to the one you use for your App Store as well. So go ahead and put in that password. Now, the next screen you may or may not have, depending on if you use iCloud or not. It says the following applications are still syncing to iCloud. If you don't want to wait until the sync completes, you may lose data. And that's fine. I don't need this one to sync. So we'll go ahead and click Continue. Next, it's going to warn you that you are about to erase all content and settings from this Mac. So go ahead and click Erase All Content and Settings if you have a backup or you want to do that. Now the computer will turn off and then it will reboot, and it will take a moment to erase everything and then boot up. So you'll have a little status bar. Just wait for that to complete and then we'll move on to the next step. Now that took about 3 minutes or so, and now we can click on the language we want and then click Continue. Now on the Activate Mac screen, you can do one of two things. If you're going to keep this for yourself, maybe you were just erasing it and wanting to start over, or you're giving it to a family member, you can connect it to a network by clicking on the icon in the upper right, selecting your network and logging in, and then activating. However, if you want to return this or you're selling it to someone else, just go to the Apple and click Shut Down, and you're done. Everything's securely erased. However, if you want to activate this to get to the setup screen so you can proceed, go ahead and click the icon in the upper right with the little network icon. Now you'll see it's connected to my network and it automatically starts to activate the Mac. So it will need that network connection to activate. So give it just a moment to activate and then we'll go to the next step. You'll see it says your Mac is activated. It will restart in 55 seconds from now, usually about a minute. So we'll click on restart, and when it comes back up, we'll be back at the main setup screen. So you can see everything booted up. We're now at the setup screen where it's writing out the word hello over and over in different languages. And you can continue to set this up. You can close it, give it away, put it in the box, return it, whatever you'd like to do. At this point, all of your data has been securely removed and your Apple ID is no longer associated with it. So you're good to go at this point. Hopefully this helped you out. And if you have any additional questions, I'd love to help you out. Just let me know in the comments below and I'll try and answer when I can. If you haven't subscribed already though, please subscribe. And if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. As always, thanks for watching. This is Aaron. I'll see you next time.